Hi! Did you know that we have orange-fleshed and purple-fleshed sweet potatoes right here in Kenya? My name is Wamboi Kerago, also known as Sara Moremi on social media. I am a passionate sweet potato farmer, and this is my story. Very tasty. You have to try it. Before I got into the sweet potatoes, I had tried my hand at the so-called high-value crops, the onions, the capsicum, pawpaws, and watermelons. But I had two main challenges with these crops. One, I had to do a lot of spraying, and I was not very comfortable with the way we were handling chemicals, and I thought it would be more interesting to work with a crop that did not require spraying, that I could do organic practices with it. The second challenge that I had with these crops is labor, because I started as a telephone farmer. It was difficult to manage labor on the phone. You know, sometimes you have two workers, but you are told you have four workers on the ground. So this was a bit challenging, and I felt I did not have my hands on the practice. So I thought I had to change my strategy. When I started the journey of searching for crops that would be minimal on labor and minimal on chemicals, I would read a lot, I would listen, I would, you know, go to social media and look at what people are doing. And then by coincidence, I had this aha moment, or the light bulb, in a restaurant in Berlin, where in their menu, I found they had sweet potato fries. And I said, let me try this. I tried, and I can tell you, there's nothing I had tasted before that was as delicious as these sweet potato fries. And I told myself, sweet potatoes are available in Kenya. How come we don't have the fries? So I thought, sweet potato, how much labor does it need? How much spraying? Zero. This was going to be my starter crop in that journey. So I came back and started searching for networks of people in sweet potatoes. I went to cafes. I discovered they had a network of professionals and farmers who were promoting orange-fleshed sweet potatoes. And that way, I landed at the orange-fleshed sweet potato. At the same time, in the same search, I discovered also the purple-fleshed sweet potato. And further reading indicated that these were actually very special when it comes to their nutritional content, to their health benefits. And I felt that this was going to be a good starting point for me. The variety that I am growing here in this farm is called the Sumaya. The difference between this one and the other range of orange-fleshed sweet potatoes is in the fiber content. It has very low fiber content. I tried with the varieties of Kenspot and Cabodet and Vita that are very much available in Western Kenya. And when I cooked them into chips or crisps, they did not come out as soft as this particular variety. So this variety, because of this element or property of low fiber, is able to give you very good crisps or chips or even puree. For me to choose these particular varieties, what attracted me first is their health benefits. At the same time, I felt that for the market, I was not going to be competitive if I did the most popular yellow or white sweet potatoes, because those are already available in the market. And I had to look at what it was that I could bring to the market that was different. And I felt that these nutritious, you know, sweet potatoes would be an addition to the market. So this, for me, was a very important point, that I had something new to add, or something, you know, of value to add to the market. The orange-fleshed and the purple-fleshed, as you look at them, they are pretty nice looking. That's one. We love beautiful things. But most importantly, it's their health benefits. With the orange-fleshed sweet potatoes, that orange pigment is you know, a characteristic of the beta carotene, the same nutrient that you get in carrot. And this is very important for because it's a precursor for vitamin A, very important for our eyesight. We all care about our eyesight, right? So that's why it is important to consume this orange flesh. Now with the purple, again, the color pigment, the purple, is a property of the anthocyanin, an antioxidant that is extremely helpful to our bodies, particularly now when we are talking about cancer cases. This particular element or antioxidant is known to prevent the cancer of the colon. Hence, consuming it will help your body to ensure that it is strong enough to prevent some of these challenges like cancer. For someone who wants to get into this type of farming of sweet potatoes, one has to factor the cost of buying the sweet potato vines. It is important that you get sweet potato vines that are certified or as clean as possible, and this may be 1 to 2 to 3 generations from the original KEFI certified seedlings. So this is very important. And normally I would say on average per acre, I would budget for about 75,000 shillings to be able to complete the space with the sweet potato vines. Another important thing is water. It's important that one has water, especially at the beginning when the seedling or the cutting is still very young and weak. It's important to have water. By the third month, you may not need as much water, but in the first, second month of establishment, it's important to have water. Manure is important because the more manure you have in the soil, the more healthy, you know, vines and tubers you will get. Here we are doing organic farming, so we are not, you know, putting any additions like, you know, spraying or anything. If there are, say, some pests, you know, eating on their leaves, we leave them eat. We believe there's enough for all. I have multiple visions for this. The first vision is I would want that my neighbors, the women neighbors in this area, have access to these vines and hence can produce for themselves the sweet potatoes. And we have already started working on this. Currently, the women around are actually welcome here to carry a few vines to go and multiply for themselves so that they have enough for their own households. And I imagine that the moment we get to commercialize, this will become the team that we'll be bulking with. So that's the first level of my vision. The second level is that I would want to see these type of sweet potatoes widespread across the 47 counties of Kenya, because orange fleshed and purple fleshed sweet potatoes should not be a niche, you know, produce. They should be available. They are nutritious. They should be available to every household. And so far, since May this year, when we started sharing out the vines at a small cost, I can confidently say we have a network of farmers in at least 20 counties, and we are still counting. We need to feed our urban population with nutritious foods. We are at an era where people are reducing consumption of wheat and replacing bread in their breakfast tables with sweet potatoes. So my vision is to have these sweet potatoes available at your local mama boga. I would want to see them in the local restaurant. I want to see them in the supermarkets as tubers. But I'm also looking at them beyond being in the form of tubers. I'm looking at them through value addition. There's a lot we can do, for example, with the orange sweet potatoes. We can do chips, like those I ate in Berlin. We can do crisps. We can do, these are Indian things called ganthia. You can even fortify, use the puree to make your ugali, your chapati. You make some very good chapatis. And at the same time, we can dry them, either use the puree or dry and have the flour to again fortify our foods. So I see us getting to the level of value addition to ensure that this produce is available across the country. It is important that we as farmers are able to feed the country with nutrient-dense foods. In a couple of years, I see this farm becoming a model farm where we can train farmers about sweet potato production, at the same time, how to add value to the sweet potato tubers. From the environmental perspective, because by training, I'm coming from environmental studies. I'm very, you know, concerned about issues of sustainable agriculture and sustainable land management. And what you find with sweet potatoes is that once they spread, they provide an extremely good soil cover. They prevent loss of soil through erosion, and they also retain the soil moisture. So they are extremely important when it comes to sustainable land management, protecting ourselves from the loss of fertility from erosion. So that was my story about the orange-fleshed and purple-fleshed sweet potatoes. You must try these two varieties. In the meantime, I'm curious about what you are doing on your farm. Share your story.